Hi, welcome to a product review by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri, presenting this review from Canada. In this video, we're going to do a review and see how we can use this XY-T01 temperature control module to control a heater or a refrigerator. Let's get started with this. So when you receive it, they have a sheet on it. Let me remove that. I bought the module for about $488 plus $1.31 Canadian. You will receive it in 30 to 50 business days, but you can select different shipping method if you want to get it faster. Let's say if you want DHL, you have to pay $34.86 to get it in 7 to 16 days. This is a thermostat or temperature control that can keep the heat or cold at a certain level or temperature is steady. You can control a heater to keep the temperature steady for whatever application you have, or you can use it for cold, which means below certain value, and you can control a refrigerator. It also has a lot of other features such as alarm if the temperature goes above or below and that hot or cold value that you set. It will make alarm and it will notice it for you. Also, it has an offset that you can set the temperature offset in case the sensor is changing or the length of wire is long. It has also some delay between the cycles. You can set it until that time passes. It will not do the next session. Temperature is monitored with this NTC temperature sensor. You will immerse or insert it in an area that you want to control. Operated with DC voltage at this input. It can operate between 6 to 30 volts. Internally, this has there is a voltage regulator that converts it, a back converter that converts it to 5 volts, including this relay. All of the circuit operates with 5 volts. I'm now connecting a external power, and I turned my light off so you can see it better. This is the temperature of this sensor at the moment in the room. I was touching it, so that's also my body temperature. If I hold this, you will see that it reacts immediately. It is set only in Celsius, not Fahrenheit, so you have to do your calculation. And now at the moment it is set at cold, meaning this will always keep it below 35. I have a buzzer here. Well, you can set an alarm and it will buzz. You have stop, set, up and down. Using the stop, you can stop it even if there is an operation or something out off. So which means the temperature changes or whatever happens, this will not react or do not control. Stop, set, up and down. Up and down or to change the value. Set is to set which value you want to change, and stop is if you want to stop the operation of this. These pins have been labeled as RX, TX and ground. We're not using them, but this device can be controlled if you find the protocol of this, so the microcontroller on this one can be controlled. On this side we have HT1621B from Holtec. This is LCD of 32x4 LCD control driver. And this is the microcontroller from Nuvoton. The model is N76E003. Here is a data sheet. I will provide you with a data sheet. This is 8-bit microcontroller. This is 8-bit microcontroller with 18 kilobytes of main flash called APROM, and it has LDROM of 4 kilobytes. And the operating voltage is 2.4 to 5.5 volts, so that's why we are using 5 volts with this. And here we have a back converter which will work with this inductor and other components. This is XL1509, a back converter. This is a data sheet. It is from XL Semiconductor, and it can operate from 4.5 to 40 volts voltage, and the output can be adjusted at 3.35 or 12 volts. Length of the module is 16.7 millimeters or 2.7 inches. The width is 42.4 millimeters or 1.67 inch. Without the spacer, the height is 17.1 millimeter or 0.67 inch. If you want to know the weight, with these spacers, it weighs 29.5 grams. Now I've connected the two wires of my bulb. I'm using this bulb, AC bulb, as my heater or refrigerator, so when this is turned on and off, it shows that the relay is working. This is an AC desktop bulb, and this is a power plug that I connected to the wall, and 120 volts, which will turn on and off. Now, at this point, I've cut one of these two wires at this point and twisted it and soldered it, can be connected to relay. Job of relay is to connect this, and the AC bulb is on, or AC load, whatever fan you have, and disconnect it to turn it off. So I will be connecting these two to the relay. Let's test it. For example, you want to set it for heat or for cold. Let's set this the cold for 45, meaning if the temperature goes above 45, the refrigerator will turn on and bring it down. So I'm pressing this. Now it's cold. If I press up and down, you will see heat or cold. So now I'm going back to cold and then press this again. Let's change this to 45. I'm using this up and down buttons. I missed the time, so let's press this again and press it again. So you have a few seconds to change it. You can press and hold, it goes down faster, or press and hold, it goes faster. 45. If I press this here, this 1 degree Celsius, I will demonstrate it with example. You have to have some value, otherwise this the value will fluctuate and the relay will turn on and off very quick. So you have to set some kind of value within 1 degree. It will allow tolerance. So that is the tolerance value. The temperature is currently at the sensor is sensing is 26.8 degrees Celsius. Now if I blow heat, and if it goes above 45, this relay will turn on and it will control my AC bulb. I'm using this heat gun, Mastercraft, and I will blow heat here. I will keep it away because it will melt this down. So as soon as it reached 45, and then the refrigerator is now started, this AC bulb is representing my refrigerator, meaning that it will cool down and the temperature will drop lower and lower until it reaches below 45, then this will be turned off, so it knows that it is cold, and it will wait until temperature goes above 45, this will turn it off. Let me just hold it in my hand so it will get cooled down quickly. Now pay attention. So this worked. Now let's set this for heat, meaning when the temperature is below certain value, it will heat it up. So this time we are using a heater. Let's say you want to keep a room or a chemical or something above 40 degrees. So let's set this at 40 high, and then heat, and then now press set again. So the temperature is, let's set it to 40. Now if I press this again, leave it at one, and then just wait, it will exit. Immediately it will turn on because the room temperature is 37 degrees. And it is going down, which means the heater will continuously turn on until the room temperature is above 40. Now let's heat this up. So when it goes, when it reaches 40, the heater will be turned off. I'm applying now heat with my heat gun. So at 40, the heater will turn off because it's now 48 degrees. Now the temperature is slowly dropping. If I hold it in my hand, my body will cool this down. You see, not exact 40, now you see 1 degree within the range. So now, because it dropped, the temperature dropped, now the heater is turning on to heat this up. Now let's have a look at the effect of the tolerance that we set at the top. Now it's set at 40 degrees, the temperature is below 40, my heater is on now, as you can see it here, and the LED also shows it is on. Press it once and press it again. This is the temperature. I'm going to the above value. Let's set it to 0. Now if I set this to 0, hold this, you can hold and exit, or maybe 6 seconds. Now the temperature is 32 degrees. Let me heat this up with my heat gun. So at 40 degrees it is turned on because it went very fast. Now let me cool it down with my finger. My body temperature will reduce it, and pay attention here when it reaches at 40 degrees. It will fluctuate a lot. Now I'm keeping away my finger from this so you can see it. Pay attention. You see, that was the reason. You have to have some value. If you have one value, it means only it gets the average of 1 degree Celsius between these values, and then turn this on, and that is eliminating any damage to the refrigerator or cooling devices that has compressor and need some time to adjust in turning on and off. So that's a very good value, and you can adjust it accordingly. Some devices need to be turned on and off in 5 minutes or 10 minutes, or maybe different value of temperature, so you can set that feature. Now let's have a look at the alarm. To set exit from heat and cold, hold this for over 5-6 seconds. You see AL, and that dash means nothing. If I set this, it will be turned on. That means 110 degrees. Let's change it to 50. I'm holding it so it can go a little fast. Now I set it at 50, just wait for 5 seconds, and it will exit. Now the alarm is set. When the temperature increases above 50, if it is in heat, it will buzz. If it is in cold, it will operate when the temperature goes below 50. Let me go to 50. At 40, the alarm, the device stopped, but we said at 50, let us know. So, as you can see, this buzzer is buzzing, and it will, and it shows W. And it will continue until somebody comes and stops it by pressing the set. And that was the W. Also shows to turn it off. Hold this for a few seconds. Now press this, and you see the dash. The alarm is off now. When it exits, you will see the W is gone. Now let's set the operating hours, because it's OPH. So hold this for a few seconds, and then press this again. You see OPH. Now OPH is activated, press this. This means minute, 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, and I can go up or down. Because of the example that I'm demonstrating, I cannot go for longer period to keep you waiting. Let's go for one and then exit. Now this is set. Now if the temperature now reaches above 40, then the light will go off. But if the temperature goes below 40, this will not turn on for 1 minute. It will wait for 1 minute before doing the task again. That is the time that we set. It reaches when temperature goes below 40, below this set value, it will wait for 1 minute to activate it before going for the next cycle. Let's have a look at this here, 40. Just pay attention here because we also set one. Now this is on. Let's assume that the heater increased the heat. And let me hold it so we can reduce the temperature quickly. Now let's have a look. You see it doesn't react. It waits for that amount of time that is set on OPH. And it now got activated. If you set that to 2, it will be twice as long, and 3, 4, and so forth. The other feature that for this one we have is, if I press and hold this for a few seconds, ALA, and then press this again, OPH, let's turn this off, and if I press this again, offset. That offset is for the temperature, and say if your sensor is sensing incorrectly, you can reduce it or you can increase it 0.5 or whatever, or even up to 10 degrees Celsius you can add or reduce. I'm not going to do it. So this was how you set that. And wait, exit, and that is set now. Thank you for watching. This was the review of XY-T01 thermostat or temperature control module. For conclusion, I could say that this is one of the best modules that you can get with this price. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, you may subscribe now.